Hey everyone, and welcome back to your VRED Expert YouTube channel. In this video, I'd like to talk about the layered material, why it was introduced, and what it can else be used for. Don't mix the layered material up with the multipass material. The multipass material is for layering materials on top of each other, like a decal or a sticker on top of another materials, and layered in terms of how Photoshop layers work. The layered material was introduced to handle multi-component materials, like a tail lamp, for example, where you have the inner whiter class and the outer red class, and these two classes are melted together and share a surface in between. There is no air or gap to handle the refractions correctly. So in my example, we have a sphere that is a solid body, so actually there is a smaller sphere in here to have a real volume, and we have the water. And the water was created with a Boolean operation of that sphere, and what we have now is that inner surface here, and we have the same surface on the sphere here as well, right? Both objects are solid. When you turn on the ray tracer in realistic rendering, you can see that these two surfaces are now intersecting with each other and create some weird effects, like these triangles here where the surfaces are intersecting. This effect is called set fighting, and VRED does not know which surface to render first. So you now can do two things. So you could make that sphere a little bit smaller by scaling it, but now there's actually a gap in between, or some air between my water and my sphere, which will create the wrong refraction and not what we want. You could also go there and simply hide one of the surfaces, but this will also create a wrong effect, as we now have only a sphere sticking into a non-solid body. And the way how it works with the layered material is that first of all, you hide one of the surfaces, it doesn't matter which one, and then you create a layer material and move both of your materials in here. So we have two class materials here, and now you can assign that layered material to that surface that is left. Keep in mind that the order of the materials inside the layered materials influence the rendering. So this result is actually wrong, as you can see that we have kind of three steps in here, and the order would be render the class first and then the water. So we now don't have any intersection, and we get actually the right refraction and also how the colors are multiplied. Another use case you can use the layered material for is when working with single-sided objects. Like here, our house of cards, there is only one surface, and you see the outer normal and the inner normal. So when now assigning a material to it, let's quickly create one. And also change the tiling to UV. You see that texture on both sides. Let's create another one. And assign the backside of my card texture to it. So if you assign that one, again, you see it from both sides. So now you can use the layered material and move both materials in here and assign that layer material to your card. So now you can see, you see the two different materials on the two different sides. The order in the layered material influences what is rendered on which side. And this is how it works. I hope you found the information helpful. Let me know what else you'd like to see on this channel. Don't forget to subscribe and see you next time. Bye.